Njeri here. Welcome back to Simi and Njeri. I'm snacking on a carrot cake and I'm going to show you how I made it. So keep watching. So what we are going to need, guys, is 1 cup wheat flour, 1/2 teaspoon of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, 1 tablespoon of baking powder. So you're going to need both of them, baking soda and baking powder. So now we mix the dry ingredients. Make sure that it is thoroughly mixed. So after we are done, we are going to set that aside. Then we prepare the wet ingredients. So the first thing that you are going to need on the wet ingredient will be 1/2 cup of vegetable cooking oil. Then 3/4 cup of sugar. And we are going to add 2 eggs. And finally, we are going to add 1 teaspoon of vanilla essence. So at this point, guys, you can use a hand mixer if you don't have an electric mixer, but I'm going to use an electric mixer. It's making my work easier and it is faster. So we are going to mix until it is smooth. So make sure your wet ingredients have mixed until they are smooth. So now we are going to add our dry ingredients. Now what we are going to do, we are going to add in small patches. So we will not mix the whole thing. So you add 2 tablespoons at a time and then we mix. As you continue adding your flour, guys, it's going to get harder, but it's okay. Once we add the carrots, it's going to be light. So right now, guys, I'm removing the excess that is on the mixer, the excess dough that is on the mixer. So the next ingredients that we are going to need are the carrots, the main ingredients for this cake. So we used 1 cup of carrot, 2 tablespoons of wheat flour. We mix them thoroughly. And then we will add on our dough. So like we did on our dry ingredients, we are going to add the carrots in portions. And this is a trick, guys, here. So when you're mixing, make sure you're mixing on one direction only. This will help our dough to get softer and our cake will come out perfectly. So you'll notice it is very hard to mix at first, but keep on adding the carrot and it will get lighter. So if your family is bigger, you need this cake to be more than the quantity that I have used. You can add your ingredients. So at this particular moment, guys, the dough is softer, as you can see. The next thing that I'm going to add on my carrot cake are raisins. And we are done, guys. So we set that aside. So I forgot to preheat my oven. So now what I'm doing is I'm preheating the oven. I'm preheating it for 10 minutes at maximum temperature. And as that is preheating, I will oil our pan that we are going to bake the carrot cake on. And I'm going to use margarine. We will make sure that our pan is well coated with margarine, as I'm doing here, and my hands are clean, guys. So make sure your hands are clean, or you can use a brush. Because I do not have a baking sheet, I'm going to pour wheat flour and then we will dab the excess off, and we are going to do it twice. It is. Actually, my husband was the one who taught me this trick. So now we add our dough. So I'm making sure I scoop everything out. I do not want to waste anything. Then we spread it evenly. So at this particular time, my oven is already warm. So I'm going to set the temperature. We put our cake in the oven, then we set the temperature. I'm going to put for 45 minutes. At 180 degrees Celsius, and we are going to heat both top and bottom part.
Much later.
So guys, as you can see, the cake is not sticking on the toothpick. That means it's ready. I'm going to take it out and we're going to wait for it to cool down and then we'll snack. You see how amazing it looks, guys. It's simple and easy. It's already cooled. It has already cooled down. Let's cut it and see how the cake looks like. Soft. So it's hot and nice. So my husband is having a taste of the cake. Sheldon. He does not want to be left out. Okay, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time. Bye, guys.